The team is constantly working on improvements to Azure Arc-enabled SQL Server. Learn all about the updates that are more like past benefits, including automated backups, point-in-time restore, and availability groups. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I have joining me from the Arc-enabled SQL Server team, Dinakar. Dinakar, thanks so much for joining us today. We're excited to have you on the show. Actually, surprising, I don't think you've been on the show maybe in years. So we're so excited to have you. Can you kick us off by telling us a little bit about what you do?
Sure. Hey, Anna. My name is Dinakar Nethi. I am a product manager in the Azure Data team. My focus is on Azure Arc. Both Arc SQL Server and Arc SQL Managed Instance. And today we'll talk about Arc SQL Server.
Okay, awesome, cool. I'm excited to learn some new things about some new things that I think have kind of relatively recently come out. Before we get into it, I'd love to get like just a high level view for folks who don't know on what is Azure Arc.
Yes, definitely. So Azure Arc is our one of the, it's been around since last year. The idea with Azure Arc is to be able to manage, govern, and secure your SQL servers that are running outside of Azure from Azure as if they're running in Azure. So on this slide, I have a host of capabilities that we are unlocking through Azure Arc. Things like being able to have a DR in the cloud to Azure SQL managed instance, being able to do your inventory and manage your SQL server from Azure portal, connect to a host of Azure services like Synapse, Purview, Defender, and Azure AD. And today we'll talk about two of the management capabilities. So the first one is automated backups and point-in-time restore. When you Arc-enable your SQL server, the built-in automated backups is disabled by default. We don't want to mess up your existing backup routines, so we keep it disabled. So in order to use this feature, you need to manually enable the backups. With the automated backups, you have two options or two knobs, if you will. The first one is the scheduling option, where you can choose to have a default schedule, and the default schedule will take a full weekly backup, daily differential backups, and 5-minute transaction log backups of all your user databases. And the other option is the custom schedule, where you can decide how often you want the full daily and the full differential and transaction log backups to happen. The second knob is the retention period. This determines how long the backups are kept. The values are from 1 to 35. You can set it to 0 if you want to disable the backups. We support full recovery mode databases today. We also back up the system databases, but for the user databases, they have to be in full recovery mode. Once your backups are scheduled and going, you have the option to do a point-in-time restore for any of those user databases, and you can restore back to a point-in-time from the first full backup all the way to the latest transaction log backup. Let's do a quick demo of it.
This is pretty amazing. Just before you get into the demo, like this is giving Azure SQL database type of capabilities to a database that's not even running in Azure. So cool. So yeah, let's take a look.
That is right, Anna. We are aligning with most of the backup restore capabilities that are already available in Azure. So customers get a streamlined experience, whether the SQL is running in Azure or outside of Azure. Okay. So what you're seeing is a Arc-enabled SQL Server overview page in Azure portal. As you can see on the left, I have a backups tab. When you click on it, I can see a list of all the available user databases on the right side. And you see that I have two databases, AdventureWorks and my test DB. And on the right side, you can see there's an action column. There's a restore action, and one of them says not available. So the second database is a brand new database I just created a few minutes ago. So the backups are not available yet. But for the AdventureWorks, you can see that there is an earliest restore point that goes back all the way to 28th September. And there is an action to restore. So there is a configure policies button at the top here. It says preview. This feature is currently in public preview. So when you click on it, you can see there's two options. the backup retention days as well as the backup schedule. Right now, my retention is scheduled to hold the backups for 10 days. I can change it all the way up to 35 days. And I can also change the backup schedule from the current schedule of 7 days to anywhere from 1 to 7 days. And the differential backup is either 12 hours or 24 hours. And the transaction log backup is incrementals of every 5 minutes. So once I configure my backup policy, I can click apply, and this gets applied to the Arc enabled SQL Server that is running outside of Azure. Now, once I have the backups, I'm able to do a point-in-time restore. For example, for AdventureWorks 2019, I can click on the restore button. This launches a new create database wizard. This is, again, in alignment with Azure SQL DB, Azure SQL MI. My source information is already pre-filled. This is the beginning of the window, September 28th, and I can restore from that point all the way until 10:23 at some point today. All I need to do is provide a database name and click next. I get a summary of my action, and I can click on review plus create. And this action will go down all the way to the Arc enabled VM that is running outside of Azure and initiate a backup, a restore from the backup files on the SQL Server that is outside of Azure.
Wow.
So that is the built-in automated backups and point-in-time restore feature.
You know, I should have thought about it, but I didn't think about like where this database was going to restore. It's pretty amazing that it actually goes down to not Azure and restores the backup. Very cool.
Correct. Yep. So that is the power of Azure Arc, where you can manage and administer your SQL servers from Azure as if they're running in Azure, but they're all outside of Azure.
Nice. Awesome. I know you said there was one other area, I think availability groups. Given what I saw here, like, I have pretty high expectations. I'm excited for this section.
All right. Let's get to that second feature. So the second feature that I want to talk about today is the always on availability groups. Always-on availability groups is a very popular high availability and disaster recovery feature that's been around for the last 4 to 5 versions, and it's very widely used and very popular. So for SQL servers that you Arc enable, and if that SQL server happens to have availability groups configured for the user databases, whether you have one AG or multiple AGs, we are able to recognize that this particular SQL server has availability groups, and we can project that information into Azure in your Azure portal blade. And you can get two things. One is the list of availability groups. You could have one, you could have 5 AGs, however many you have. And the second part, this is the more interesting part, is the AG status. Now, the status of availability groups is a real-time status. So what happens is when you click on the availability group and get to that status page, from Azure portal, we go down to the Arc enabled SQL Server, the VM that is running the SQL Server. The agent will run a bunch of DMVs, AG related DMVs against your SQL Server, collect the status information and send it back to Azure, which is a full round trip back. And on your portal, you will see this information real time. So let's look at the demo quickly. Okay, so what you're seeing on this page is a Arc enabled SQL Server. And on the left, you can see there is a tab called Availability Groups. So when I click on this, it's a round trip again. It will get the list of availability groups. And when I click on the availability group, this is the real-time status that it's reaching down to the Arc-enabled VM, retrieving the status and showing you who is the current primary, what is the AG status, who are the secondaries, what is the synchronization status. Pretty much what you get in the SSMS AG dashboard view is what you get here.
Wow.
So this is the availability group feature that we are very excited about. And that's all I have for you, Anna, today.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Dinakar, for coming on the show. I got to say, like, one, I learned a lot. And two, I'm really excited about all the capabilities that are coming to Azure Arc. Because now, like you said, you're bringing the power to Azure to the SQL servers running all over the place. So even if they're not... Even if it's not a platform as a service or PaaS service, you can still get those types of benefits without moving to the cloud. So super cool to see these things land. Dinakar, I just want to thank you so much for coming on Data Exposed. To our viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what you think. We'll put some links in the description for you to learn more, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.